What's up guys, Sly here and welcome back to South Park the Fractured Butthole. So we are going now to discuss who... Hey, he has a phone. Who gives so much money to Butters? Or Professor Chaos, or we call him.
What the fuck, are you trying to exterminate us all?
Okay, let's sit and let's see what's going on.
What if the person paying Butters wasn't a kid?
Is that it, Chaos? Were you paid by an adult?
I'm telling you, I don't know his name, fellas. Nobody does. He's just trying to unite all the crime families in town. He's everywhere. He's nameless, faceless. He can change his appearance like the wind changes direction.
Wait, what did you say?
He says there's a revolution coming, and the darkness of our own hearts will bring about our undoing.
Oh my god.
He is that which liberates, and he knows the true weakness of tolerance. And his coming will bring about a tide of chaos like nothing we've never seen, you mentioned.
Oh my god. Could it be? No, it's impossible.
What's impossible?
There's only one person I know of who can disguise himself so easily. And it's the same person who might have a motive for tearing South Park apart.
Who?
Mitch Connor.
Mitch Connor? Oh, no. No, 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 no.
Who's Mitch Connor?
It's Cartman's dumbass hand puppet.
You know damn well that Connor was just using my hand to suit his needs. At first, he disguised himself as Jennifer Lopez, who loves tacos and burritos. When his cover was blown, he was arrested by the police, but escaped. But why would he want to take down South Park?
And where would he get all his money?
Shut up! It's not Mitch, stupid fucking Connor! How do you know?
No, Kyle is right, you guys. It couldn't be Mitch Connor. Connor died in an oil rig explosion in northern Alaska.
Fuck this. I'm going to bed.
Yes, yes, good idea, humankind. Everyone get back to your homes, it's getting late. Let's all reconvene tomorrow. After... ski...
And now, the news program that starts your day off right. Good morning, South Park!
Good morning.
South Park vigilante struck again last night, this time at a meth lab in the downtown New Stort facility. Here with more is a midget in a fedora. Tom, six people were arrested last night after the vigilante exposed a huge meth lab in the storage facility behind me. Eyewitnesses have come forward with shocking reports that the vigilante's farts were so awful they seemed to actually rip the fabric of time.
You ain't never heard a fart like this, man. It was like one minute he farted on my dick and the next thing my dick was like 20 seconds in the past.
Finally, someone is standing up to all the crime in this city. If you ask me, these people here all deserve to be farted on.
He's a menace, if you ask me. How long before this vigilante gets radical and blows up a school or a church, huh? How long before Captain America becomes Captain Ideology? Huh? The third Captain America movie? How long was that? About 6 years? About 6 years! Dozens of protesters gathered outside the police station today as a warrant was issued for the vigilante's arrest.
This city will not be victimized by mass crusaders who sneak around and fart on people at night. We urge all citizens to arm themselves and fight against this kind of rectal oppression.
Oh, what the hell?
Yeah, it's me. Nobody knows anything about this kid. Not what race he is, not even if it's a boy or a girl. What do we do, sir?
Just keep getting the product into people's drugs and alcohol. I'll handle the vigilante.
This deal's getting out of control. You said you could get the mayor out of office.
You wanted to be left alone, Commissioner. To do what you love doing. I've made that happen. Just stay calm and soon everyone will have exactly what they want.
So it's Cartman, all the time.
Hey kid, wait up! You are the new kid, right? My name's Wendy. Nice to have you at our school. That little problem Call Girl told you about? It's a lot worse. The Chamber of Commerce wants to get rid of the vigilante no matter what it takes. You know the bathrooms in the park? Call Girl wants you to meet her there, right now. Yeah, anyway, nice to have you in town, new kid!
Yeah, sure, whatever. Oh, I need to change. Oh, hell yeah. What you...
See? You just spun around and different clothes came on.
That's dumb.
I'm gonna fucking get you, kids, and...
I need all Coon and friends to report to the Coon Lair. Repeat,
All Coon and friends, report to the Coon Lair!
Oh my gosh. Okay, firstly, I think I'm going to the park.
Need to get somewhere fast, you kid? Better run fast! There you go!
So, thank you.
Hello there, new kid. We haven't been formally introduced. I'm Mr. Crime Syndicate Kingpin Guy, and you are the one who keeps farting on all my best people.
Are we really so different, you and I? We both want what's best for this city. I know you've probably got places to be, but why don't you come talk to me instead? I'm at the old Soto Sopa ruins. Come on. What do the Coon friends really have to offer you?
Alright, so... thing is, now where should I go? It's getting confused. Did she stay at a girl's locker room, restroom?
You have to admit, the best part about being a girl is that our bathrooms are clean. Anyway, I've got a problem, new kid. I'm like you, an outsider. I've been watching as adults in our town act stranger and stranger, but nobody will listen to me. I started cross-referencing everyone's Instagrams to see what kind of connection I could find. And that's when it happened. Somebody canceled my cellular data plan. My phone is dead. Whoever did this has to pay. I'm going to the mobile company to find out what happened. I can't go alone. I'm asking for your help, new kid. I think you're the only one who understands.
Okay. So many questions are coming now. What exactly to do? So we are almost there. There she is.
All right. Are you ready to do this?
Yes.
If I can't use my mobile devices, I can't save this town. Let's go find out what's wrong with this place.
Welcome to D-Mobile. Can I help you?
Grab people, look like grab. Work at mobile stores like people.
Yeah, I'm having a lot of problems connecting to the internet.
Your name and D-Mobile number, please. Your name and D-Mobile number, please.
Wait a minute. You weren't the people who worked here last week.
That's right. We are grab people.
Shh.
We are glad people to work in this fine place. Can I interest you in a new contract with up to 5 gigabytes of data per month?
No, I just want my phone to work right.
Excellent, human! How dare you shout our data plan?
I knew it. The phone company's been taken over by crab people.
She's on to us.
Call girl, save us!
Come on, new kid. Let's wipe the floor with them.
Yeah, the behind the corner are the real people. Call girl, save us. How do they know who she is? So, crab people are my weakness.
Don't
Okay, let me see. We can't hit them.
Nice one, but we have to get to the king or we're screwed.
Yeah, I knew it. He would call more. Not your turn.
You got blocked.
So I can use my ulti. What's her ulti? Let's see. Damage and defense down to all foes. Okay, that should really do it.
I just auctioned off all your passwords and now you're part of a Russian botnet. Sorry.
What the hell?
I must be trapped in the corner. We have mail.
Who are you gonna call? That's right.
That was disgusting.
Oh, thank you, call girl. I don't know what those things were, but they smelled like crab and kissed like people. How can we repair you?
Just get my phone working again.
How do you mean kiss like
people? Yes, of course, call girl.
No, I don't want to know. No. Store.
Once again.
Thanks, new kid. But I have a feeling this isn't over. If you smell crab, call me.
Oh my gosh. What the? Take? What the hell? Am I even taking there? Scrap tech, food, biohearts. Oh my gosh, that's.
No, girls. Allowed.
So.
You kind of. Okay, here's Farty Pants now. Come join us.
Yeah, I'm coming. So, what's the matter?
Coon friends, these are dark times. We now know for a fact that Scrambles the Missing Cat is part of a larger conspiracy. We also know that the fucking Freedom Pals have more information about this conspiracy than we do. Fact.
Maybe we should just face it, guys. Maybe Freedom Pals have a better super franchise than we do.
Hey, that's no way to talk, Mosquito! The only reason that Freedom Pals are ahead of us right now is because they're butt-fucking cheaters who sold out!
Yeah, but Freedom Pals have Dr. Timothy and he can read people's minds and bend reality.
Yeah, because he just said that. When we made up our superpowers, he was like, well, I have every power to do fucking everything. You think that's fair? It's time for us to be as dirty as them. We have to know what the Freedom Pals know. Well, how are we ever going to get the help of the Freedom Pals? We send a spy. Someone in our group who pretends to want to switch sides and join Freedom Pals. Somebody who they don't know very well. The new kid joins Freedom Pals, then asks for assistance investigating the community city.
Hope the new kid is good at bullshitting.
You'll never get past the security grids. They change it every day.
I can get the new kid inside. I've got hacking abilities, remember? Because I'm a gadgeteer class with the tinkering ability.
No dice, Chaos. You're just saying that to get out of jail.
You better let him go. The new kid will need him.
All right, fine.
Beep, beep, beep.
Beep. Get the new kid inside Freedom Pals base.
Okay.
If he tries anything funny, kill him.
All right. Finally playing again with Butters. Meet Professor Chaos at Butters' home. Okay, but I'm going to end this episode here now. So we will then go with Butters and investigate. So he has the hacking skill. I didn't even expect.
Oh, hello, new kid. Did you lose your crown?
How do you know about my
goodness.
Crown? It was last
goodness.
Week. Okay, I'm not. So it was fun to play with Call Girl, but we also met some of the crab people. So I don't get it if they are coming back. So they tried to get into the phone system to cut it off. Do they have something to do with Cartman? I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Just a little gag there. But anyways, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.